Hey y'all, my name's Travis Harper. I'm from Snow Hill, North Carolina, and I'm a world traveler. I've traveled to 36 American states and 9 different countries since last May of 2016. I started traveling abroad in Costa Rica and Nicaragua. 4 months after that, I went to Europe and visited Germany, Austria, Italy, and Switzerland. This film focuses on my latest journey to South America, where I visited Peru, Bolivia, and Chile for 1 month. I had the time of my life, met some amazing people, ate some awesome food, and just had an all-around amazing experience, and I want to share it with you guys. Thanks for tuning in and traveling with Travis. So after a 5-hour bus ride, a 3-hour trek down train tracks, one night at a hostel, an hour and a half of hiking up the mountain, we made it to Machu Picchu.
My most difficult experience in South America was the trek up Rainbow Mountain. I went from Lima, Peru, which is at sea level, to 21,000 feet in less than 24 hours, and my lungs could definitely tell. We've all heard heard the saying that the toughest climbs come with the best views, and I finally learned for myself that that saying was true. In Peru were awesome. They seemed carefree, like they didn't have a worry in the world. I guess that just goes to show it doesn't take a lot to be happy. The kids in Peru start working at a really young age. They're selling souvenirs, food, things in the street just to help their family. The coolest part about Machu Picchu is that no one really knows how the Incas built this city or why they even lived. And I think that's why it's such an amazing place. Don't go to Machu Picchu expecting to understand it. I took a flight from Cusco, Peru to La Paz, Bolivia, not knowing that I had to have a visa to enter the country. But I got my visa and I got my Bolivianos and I was on the way.
La Paz?
Una Paz City.
The first thing I did after I checked into my hostel was walk up on the rooftop. There was a guy from France playing a half ukulele and half guitar. There was a dude from Beijing, China, playing anything he can get his hands on. And there was even a girl up there from North Carolina. It was kind of strange being that far away and still meeting somebody from home.
Talk some shit! Let's talk some shit! Some real shit!
Sing it.
Southern Appalachia right there. So fun. You know, I hear wagon wheel play all over the world.
The person that inspired me the most on this trip was the Chinese guy, Adam. He bought a motorcycle in Alaska, and he drove it all the way to Argentina.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, all my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine.
Thank you.
have all the time in the world.
At the top of everything that I climb.
Four, three, two, one, there it goes. The mouth harp.
What the fuck?
Someone just threw a water balloon in there. Yeah.
One of the places I wanted to visit the most on this trip to South America was the Amazon. I booked a 15-hour trip by bus, and if I would have known what the trip was like beforehand, I probably wouldn't have booked the ticket. It was up and down mountains, through twists and turns on the cliff sides, with nothing but death whenever you look over. Seeing how the people in Bolivia were living was a very humbling experience. They didn't have much, but it seemed like they just had enough. The bus ride might have been a little stomach turning, but the views were so beautiful that was worth it. After that 15-hour bus ride, we ended up in a place called Rurrenabaque, where we met up with our tour guide and he took us to the beginning of the Amazon. As we were riding the boat down the river, one of the first animals we got to see was the squirrel monkey. We even saw the baby monkey riding on the mama monkey's back. We even saw the capybara, the biggest rodent species in the world.
So this is our location. Here's the boat we rode in on. And here is the caiman that almost ate us whenever we pulled up.
And this is the little shack we slept in. It wasn't long before the monkey showed up, and they didn't show up peacefully. They broke into our shack, and they stole some of our fruit and left trash all over the place. Everywhere you looked, there were caimans crawling around. On our second day in the Amazon, our tour guide parked the boat, got off, and we followed him through a river. Little did we know that he was taking us fishing. Piranha fishing. The people in my group had a little better luck fishing than I did, but they were still generous enough to share the piranha with us at dinner that night. We spent our last day in the Amazon on my 24th birthday. We got to see a couple of sloths, and it was the coolest birthday I ever had. The next place in Bolivia I had on my mind was Sol de Uyuni. This place is located in southwest Bolivia in the desert, and is home of the world's biggest salt flats. Sol de Uyuni is a legacy of a prehistoric lake that went dry, leaving behind a desert-like landscape of bright white salt, rock formations, and cactus-filled islands. There was nothing but salt and sky as far as the eye could see. We drove through the desert of southwest Bolivia for 3 days, and it was the most breathtaking views I'd ever seen in my life. It was an awesome experience hanging out with people from all over the world, from Bolivia, Spain, England, South Korea, the time came to say goodbye to my new friends. When Bolivia ended, the road to Chile began.
ask myself for peace. And found it at my feet.
That's all, folks. That's all I got. I hope y'all enjoyed watching it just as much as I enjoyed playing it for you. I'm back home on the farm now in North Carolina with my family, my nieces and nephews, and I wouldn't want to be anywhere else. This trip really just showed me that it doesn't matter where you go or who you meet, what country you're from or what language you speak, that we're all the same and we all are just people and just want to travel the world and get inspired by each other. So I hope y'all enjoyed watching it. Y'all have a great day. And I'll see y'all next time. We go traveling with Travis.
I see the sunrise creeping in. Everything changes like the desert wind. Here she comes and then she's gone again. And I'm just a traveler on this earth. Sure have my heart behind the pocket of my shirt. I just keep rolling till I'm in the dirt. Cause I'm a traveler. Oh, I'm a traveler. Turning on.